I'm going to answer this question a little differently. The way I would answer looking for investors in general really has less to do with social or non-social, but more to do with how that investor lets you control your business. I today don't own the majority of the business, but I control the majority of the business, which really secures me in my position here as CEO now for about 10 years. The way we did that is at the beginning, we first raised money from business plan contests. We raised about 100 grand by entering and winning various business plan contests, and it was a great way to raise money while not giving up any part of the business. Then we started raising money from angel investors. And angel investors we really like because they have long-term perspectives. They're willing to invest even sizable amounts. Our angels range from $50,000 investments up to $500,000 investments. And they're highly flexible, very, very long-term. And by definition, they're investing in the individual like me, but also in the vision and mission of the business, not just the raw economic fundamentals. And because we went so heavy on angels, which created a very diverse group of shareholders, and then only took a few funding sources of institutional investors, but by then they weren't really controlling a big part of our business, we've been able to be in a very, very good spot where we have great investors that are looking at this at a very, very long time period and or very long horizon, if you will, and are not putting pressure in really bad ways on the business, like either replacing me, which would suck for me, but also making us do short-term decision-making, which many time investors who have five-year windows do. And that's one of the big challenges with institutional venture capital is that they do have a five-year window, and that makes it very difficult when you're getting near the end of that window to be able to do the right things for the business.